हेलो ऑल, आई डॉक्टर दीपक कुमार वेलकम्स यू। सब्जेक्ट इज बेसिक ऑफ वीडियो कैमरा लाइट्स एंड साउंड। टॉपिक रोल्स ऑफ कंपोजिशन। रोल्स ऑफ कंपोजिशन। इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस्ड सर्टेन रोल्स दैट वर रोल ऑफ थर्ड, लुकिंग स्पेस, वॉकिंग स्पेस। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस हेडरूम, डायरेक्टिंग अटेंशन, लाइफलेस शॉट्स, सिमुलेटिंग डेप्थ, विजुअल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड स्टेटिंग कंपोजिशन। द लास्ट वन इज डायनामिक कंपोजिशन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ हेडरूम। नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज हेडरूम। हेडरूम रेफर्स टू द अमाउंट ऑफ स्पेस बिटवीन द टॉप ऑफ पर्सन्स हेड एंड द टॉप ऑफ योर फ्रेम। मेक श्योर दैट द पर्सन्स आईज फॉल ऑन द अपर थर्ड लाइन। डोंट मेक ए शॉट टू क्लोज टू द टॉप दैट द पर्सन्स हेड इज चॉप्ड ऑफ। लाइक इन दिस इमेज the frame is not good because the head is chopped off. There should be a space between the person's head and the edge of screen. Also, don't be too close to the bottom that the person looks like they are sinking. Here in this image, there is a lot of space between the person's head and the edge of the screen, but this is too much. It looks like she is sinking in the frame. So what is the perfect frame? Here is an example of the perfect frame where there is a nominal space between the subject, the artist head and the edge of screen. Directing attention. Use colors to direct a person's attention to something. Using color can direct a person's attention directly to something. Like in this image, the butterfly on the flower is the first thing we notice in the picture. So use colorful things to draw attention of viewer. Next is directing attention. Put your subject or object on the contrast background to make it pop. Here is an example. The background is dark and the leaf is bright. So here is contrast between the background and subject. So it will make the viewers attentive and it looks nice. Frame the subject with object such as branches, signs or walls. This direct attention to the subject. We can make a frame using branches of trees, using any signboard, using wall, any artificial thing. Now here in the image, the branches of the tree are making a frame and there is a house in the background. Next is lifeless shots. No movement or life in the shot. These might make nice photos but not good for videos. Don't have people pose in lifeless positions. Think of something they should do, then direct them to do it while you are shooting. Think what they would do in the real life when that particular action is taking place. Like in this image, the lady is giving a pose. There is no movement in the sword. And this is a good photograph. But if we will shoot or we will record in video, this sword is lifeless. There is no movement. No movement means no life in the sword. There must be some movement in the swords. Or the swords must look like, but there is some motion in the subject or object. In a photo, it is okay to have a person pose, but in a video, though, we need to show movement and action. Here are some examples. All the three images are showing some action. These are good for still photography also, as well as if we will make the video of these swords, then they will draw attention of viewers and there will be some life in the swords. So movement is must, action is must in a video to shoot. Next one is simulating depth. By placing an object or person closer to the camera, it increases the depth in the picture. This helps the video look more 3D and less flat. As we can see in the image, that object is placed closer to the camera. This is increasing the depth of the picture. These the sculpture of three birds are creating depth of the depth in this image, in this shot. Here is one more example for simulating depth. Next one is visual organization. Simplicity, the simpler and less cluttered the shot is, the clearer it will be to the viewers. Here are example of simplicity. In this image, there are too many persons in the frame and viewers will not be able to understand where they have to concentrate. In this image, a single child is playing and it is clear where the viewers have to give their attention. So such type of shots are not appreciable, are not very good for videos. They may be good for photographs, but for videos, the framing should be simpler and less cluttered. The clearer, more clearer it will be, the more attentive and the more attractive the frame will be. Next one is static composition. Static composition refers to the shots where the lines in the view tend to be very strictly vertical or horizontal. As we can see in the image, the lines of the people, the steps and the water are neat horizontal lines, as well as the people being in neat vertical columns. These lines tend to be soothing, calm, tranquil to the viewer. So there, this is the example of static composition, where we use lines to make some good shots. All the people are horizontally and vertically in line, standing in line, and this is giving a pleasant video. Next one is dynamic composition. The opposite of static composition, dynamic composition entails the structure of a frame being composed of many diagonal lines. In static composition, we use horizontal and vertical lines. In dynamic composition, we make a frame using many diagonal lines. Audience gain excitement and interest from these lines as they break the tranquility of static composition. It can be quite hard to create diagonal line naturally, but by using certain camera angle and tilt lines that were originally vertical and horizontal become diagonal. Here is an example of the frame. Now, last but not the least thing, breaking the rule. Like many rules, compositional rules can be broken to create equally interesting and unique shots. And there is a saying that there are no rules of composition, and if there is, then the rule is that break the rules. Many a times we can break the rules to create a very good composition. Here are two examples of breaking of rule, but these are very attractive compositions. There in this image we are breaking the rule of headroom, but still the frame is very attractive, the image is, and the shot is very impressive. Here in this image we are breaking the rule of looking space, but still the frame and composition very attractive and very impressive. So that's all for today. We will meet with a new topic again. Till then, thank you.